What is good? What it do? We're back with the Madden 06 Browns. I know it's been a hot minute, but look at these stats, man. We're lighting it up, man. So we're taking on the Denver Broncos. They're 2-9. They're not very good. Aaron Brooks is doubtful, which means it's going to be either Quinn Gray or Adrian McPherson. I believe McPherson gets the start over Quinn Gray. Tiki Barber's out, so we got to go against Deshaun Foster, who's not that bad of an alternative, I'm not going to lie. And they got their best receiver is Antoine Randall. That's when you know. No offense to Antoine. He's cool. I met him. Super cool guy. But he's not a superstar. Never was. He even admitted he'd rather play baseball than football if he could go back and make another decision. Because of, like, you know, all the long-term effects from football. Yeah. But anyway, neither here nor there. We are checking out this team. Grant Wistrom. I actually know somebody that's from the same area as that dude. Small world, man. I know a lot of people. But yeah, that dude was a beast, from my understanding, a little before my time, but you know. They got Adam Pac-Man Jones as their best corner, and that was when he was a young cat in this game. He was a rookie, I think, in Madden 06. So yeah, they don't have the greatest team, man. I'm not even gonna lie, I'm not trying to disrespect them, but hey, neither here nor there, we gotta perform. And kicking a kickoff like that, like dang, you gotta completely whiff that and hit it with like the outside of your foot to kick it like that. That was awful. Right here, Deshaun Foster bowls over Ed Reed, but Sean Taylor, he's going to knock Deshaun Foster out of bounds. And yeah, Ed Reed's hurt. He hurt his chest, so he's a little banged up from the play. Here's Deshaun Foster. See him, he's shaking his head. He's trying to shake the cobwebs out. You know, he does look kind of tough in that dark visor. I ain't going to lie. He got a nice run there. Second down and three. They give it to him again. He's picking up the first down on that run. So far, so good for Denver. I ain't going to lie. They put in another running back, but that's not going to work. Second down and nine now. Hand off to Jensen again, and he's going to be put down. So that brings up third down for the Broncos. McPherson looking into the flats. That's tipped up, and Randall L comes down with it. Fourth down, though, so they got to bring out the kicker. The kicker, he hits that really low, but that field goal is good. First down, Clinton Portis. That's only going for a couple yards. Second down now, Portis bounces it outside. He's making moves across the 40. And yeah, first down right there. That's going nowhere. And Portis coughs up the football, but he recovers his own fumble. So I was like, yeah, no point in challenging it because it would have been the same spot anyway. Second down now. Ronnie Brown is in the game. And Ronnie Brown catching the ball out of the backfield, getting a solid gain. Ed Reed, he bruised his ribs, so he's going to be out two quarters from getting bowled over by Deshaun Foster. No way to sugarcoat that. You got bowled over. You got trucked. Right there, Mike Vick got sacked. Second down, looking for Jabbar Gaffney. Nice play by the linebacker, knocking that away. Third down now, Mike Vick looking for Portis out of the backfield. Clinton Portis comes down with it. What the heck? I didn't even think he was going to catch that. I'm not even going to lie. Right there, though, but Portis coughs up my football, though. So that's his second fumble on the same drive. This time he loses it, though. So, yeah, not looking good. First down to Sean Foster. He's going to take another hit stick from Sean Taylor. Sean Taylor not playing around with this dude. I'm telling y'all. Right there, that was almost picked off by Torber, but instead it tips into the hands of McCarron's. And yeah, he gets the catch. Third down, McPherson looking. That was almost picked off too. First down and 10. Portis trying to get outside. That was not the smartest decision. But you know, it's stretch play is intended to go outside, not inside. Right here, looking for Randy Moss on the corner. That was inaccurately thrown. And Moss, you know, couldn't catch up to it. Third down, looking for Stallworth. He can't hold on the dig. So that brings up fourth down. We had to punt. First down now for the Broncos. Deshaun Foster getting what he can. Second down and five. Now counterplay to Deshaun Foster. Tries to turn it upfield. That's not going to work. Our linebacker's waiting right there. Third down now. Play action. McPherson rolling to his right. And he's going to launch that one about 70 yards down the field. Okay, McPherson. But that is ridiculously overthrown. That's worse than our overthrows. Right there. That's knocked away. Second down and 10. Play action. Mike Vick looking. Rolling to his left. Taking a shot deep to Stallworth. Who beats his man deep, and that's a touchdown for Cleveland. Dante Stallworth gets behind the defense. I mean, he's got 97 speed. He can move like Marwin Greenwood. He's got that lateral mobility I like. James Thrash, he got hurt on the punt return, actually. Or no, excuse me, no, the kick return coverage he got hurt on. So he is out for the game. But you know what? It is all good because Lito Shepard can be our return man again. He was last year. That was incomplete. McPherson threw that to nobody. First down, Ronnie Brown trying to get what he can. Second down and nine, Vic drops back. Dumps it to Antonio Gates. That's a catch. Third and a few coming up. Handoff is the Portis. and he is going to lower his shoulder, and he's going to just pick up the first down. That was very close. First down play action. Mike Vick rolling to his left. He's going to dump it to Portis out of the backfield, and Clinton Portis is on the loose. He's outside. He's going inside the 20. Okay, Clinton Portis. First down, Mike Vick rolling to his right. He's going to take off with it. Spin move on the defender. Tries to spin move again, but he bumps into the defender and goes down. First down, though, Clinton Portis. Man, I don't even know if he got touched on that play. Touchdown, Cleveland. McPherson. He's going to throw a snap screen to Justin McCarron's. McCarron's makes a move, and Justin McCarron's up the sideline, man. Oh, that was a good developed play. I'm not going to lie. I thought we had him in the backfield, but apparently not. That's 80-some yards for a touchdown by Justin McCarron's. First down, Clinton Portis spinning upfield. He's going to pick up a first down on that run. Play action now. Mike Vick looking. Taking a shot deep to Randy Moss. That's out of bounds. Take it down in 10. Mike Vick drops back. Rolling to his left. Finds Stallworth, who's going to bring it in, but he's going to be a bit short of that first down. So we run no huddle. We run the same exact play. Third and a couple. Mike Vick drops back. He's going to roll to his left. Looking, floats that one over the defense to Portis. He brings it in for the first down. First and 10. Mike Vick looking. Looking for Randy Moss on the corner. And that is going to be knocked away by the defense. So they're doing a good job keeping Randy Moss in check. Second down now. Portis. He's going to get the outside. Clinton Portis. He's inside the 35-yard line. Tackled around the 31 on that carry. First down, we give it to Ronnie Brown. He's going to break a tackle. Spin move on the defense. Ronnie Brown is making people miss. First down and 10. Mike Vick drops back. Looking for Gaffney. He finds Jabbar Gaffney. Spin move, and Jabbar Gaffney almost scores. And Denver has to burn a timeout because Jabril Wilson is shaken up on the play. First down. Clint Portis into the end zone for the second time today. That's a touchdown for Cleveland. So the Browns trying to get something going. Excuse me, the Broncos. And yeah, that's not going to work. Picked off by Lito Shepard. They trying to get something going at the end of the half. And they don't get the ball to start the second half. We do. Taking a shot deep to Stallworth because we can still get points. That's going to be incomplete. Second down and 10, Mike Vick. Stretch play to Clinton Portis. That's going nowhere. Broncos defense on that. Third down and 10, Hail Mary. And no, Michael Vick, running with Michael Vick on Hail Mary is cheating. But look who we find downfield behind the defense again. Touchdown, Dante Stallworth. There we go. Look at Cleveland. And we get the ball to start the second half. Starting off the second half running with Ronnie Brown. Second down play action. Mike Vick looking. They double team Randy Moss, so we're going to take off. Mike Vick. Oh, if he had made that dude miss, he might have been able to break loose and score on that, believe it or not. It's all good, though. Neither here nor there. First down. We had both Portis and Gates. We overthrow Gates, and he doesn't jump up and try to make an effort to catch the ball. I think if he jumped up, he might have been able to catch it. I mean, he has that basketball background, remember? But you know what? Neither here nor there. We got to make a stop for our turnover. McPherson. Drops back. That's incomplete. Third down now. Deshaun Foster. He bowls over a man. Oh, no, I think that was Sean Taylor. Oh, no. I mean, when I'm controlling Sean Taylor, he doesn't get run over. Right there. Clinton Portis with a solid gain. Second down. Clinton Portis stopped for no gain. Maybe even a loss. Third and 7. We try to take off with it, but we bump into our linemen, and their linemen grab us. So, yeah. We had a punt. First down. Pass complete to Brad Gardner. First round pick, he was pretty much a bust. Remember the Reds? I don't remember, but the Redskins took him and he did nothing. Right there, Ian Gold with a nice blitz off the edge. Look at that beautiful execution. McPherson doesn't even see it coming. I'm surprised he held on to the football through that hit because he was like turned backwards and everything. He should have. Normally, he would fumble. I know Jake Cutler would have fumbled that. Right there, he's going to find Lewis, the aging tight end. That was with the Eagles, I think, in reality. And third down, they're going to find Justin McCarron's for the first down. Now the handoff goes to Deshaun Foster. Stutter steps. Now he's going to go. And second down and 4. Foster again. Trying to cut back to the right. And it looks as if Randy Starks is the one in on the play. Third down, Foster. That's going to be a first down for Denver. Now first and goal. Play action. Excuse me, never mind. That was a handoff to Foster. Sean Taylor's there for the tackle. Second down and goal, they give it to Jensen this time. Deshaun Foster's a little tired, I guess, from all those carries. Third down now, empty backfield. McPherson looking, scanning the field, but he's going to go down to OJ Atogwe with the sack. Fourth and goal, they're going to go for it. McPherson looking in the back of the end zone. That's going to be called turnover on downs. It was very close. I know Randall L for a fact got 1 foot. I couldn't really see the second in the replay, but Denver did not challenge. So, hey, life moves on. We have the ball. Mike Vick looking, finds Antonio Gates on play action. That's going to be a first down for Cleveland. Mike Vick drops back, looking. Finds Randy Moss on the hitch. He's going to be tackled almost immediately. Not the most accurately thrown ball. Randy Moss made him look good, not going to lie. Second down now, Mike Vick rolling back to his left, looking for somebody, looking for Portis. That's over his head, incomplete. Third down now, Mike Vick looking. Rolling to his left, taking a shot deep. Randy Moss brings it in. Why would you put a linebacker on him? Denver, you're so stupid. That's like the ultimate clownish decision. Second down and 9. Handoff goes to Ronnie Brown. He's going to bounce it outside. Spin move, and he's going to pick up the first down. These spin moves are nasty on this game. I'm not going to lie. If you do them right. Right here, looking for Randy Moss in the end zone. Pac-Man Jones misplays the ball, and that's a touchdown for Randy Moss. You can't do that with Randy Moss. So right here, the Broncos looking for something. That was almost another pick for Lito Shepard. Great play to high point the football and knock it away. McPherson looking again. Looking for his man. He finds him. Looks like I think his name is Rojas. Anyway, as I was saying, third down. That's incomplete, and that was game. We ended up winning 38-10, I believe. Yeah, because we got a field goal literally as time expired. But yeah, no, the Broncos weren't really much of a match for us. Maybe it would have been a little more interesting if they had Tiki Barber and Aaron Brooks. I feel like Aaron Brooks running around would have given us some problems. But neither here nor there. They got to stay healthy to play us. They do have a Hall of Famer in Will Shields on that line. But yeah, see, Josh Kobe made a really, really short field goal. But yeah, we got that money.